Hi there, it's Christmas soon, or Yule, as we call it here in Scandinavia. They could never get us to use the new name for it. Scandinavians can be really stubborn when they want to. The Nisse is a very popular character here. At this time of year, he's everywhere. Both in the shops and as decorations in homes. These days, the Nisse is mostly associated with the winter solstice and Yule. He doesn't come through the chimney at night, though. He comes through the front door on Christmas Eve and hands the gifts directly to the receiver. Although he's been modernized, he's still not the Coca-Cola Santa you see elsewhere. He may be dressed in red most times, but he isn't as obese. Less bright and shiny, doesn't say ho ho ho, and his beard is straighter and longer. Nisse is the Norwegian word, and tomte is the Swedish word. Before I forget, this video has a link to the list of images I've used because that amount of text wouldn't fit in the YouTube description. It links to a Google Docs file where you can go check out who created the images. I'll do my best to add them on the image as well. The Nisse was often imagined as a small, elderly man with a full beard, dressed in the traditional farmer garb in earth tones, with a pointy hat in red or some other bright color. There were several kinds of Nisse. You have the forest kind, the farm kind, and the house Nisse as well. Most of the time, people speak about the farm Nisse. He was primarily connected to farm animals, but his favorite was the horse. People believed that you could see which horse was the Nisse's favorite, as it would be very healthy and well taken care of. Sometimes the Nisse would even braid its mane and tail. According to tradition, the Nisse lived in the houses and barns of the farm and secretly acted as their guardian. If you treated him well and took good care of the farm and the animals, he would protect the family and animals from evil and misfortune, and might also help with chores and farm work. He was a traditionalist in that he didn't like changes in how things were done. He was also easily offended by rudeness, carelessness, lack of proper respect, and lazy farmers. His payback ranged from small pranks like slap or knotting the tails of cows, to more severe things like killing off the livestock, burning down the farm, or ruining the farm's fortune. If anyone spilled something on the floor in the house, it was customary to shout a warning to the Nisse. You should also please him with gifts, in particular a bowl of porridge on Christmas Eve or Solstice Eve. This was his payment for the year's work. If the Nisse didn't get his payment, he'd leave the farm or house or engage in mischief such as tying the cow's tails together in the barn, turning objects upside down and breaking things. The Norwegian Nisse likes his porridge with a piece of butter on top, by the way. And I still set out a bowl for him on the eve of the winter solstice. Since the Nisse folk around here are Norwegian, I do serve it with butter the Norwegian way. Some still blame the house Nisse when things go missing in the house and can't be found until you no longer need them. So they can be very useful in that way when you put something in a safe place. But there have been many times when I have literally turned the drawer or bag upside down and gone through every single piece of its content without finding what I was looking for, only to find it clearly visible in that same drawer or bag later on when I didn't need it. Have you had some dealings with the Nisse? Have a wonderful holiday, by whatever name you call it. Make sure to spend it doing things you love with people you love. I'll be back in January since I'm taking some family time during the holidays. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and subscribe if you haven't. Check out the cards and the end screen for more of my videos. And until next time, bye-bye.